According to Inc. magazine, the fastest growing company in Louisiana grew last year by an astonishing 2,775%. Was it an energy company? No. Was it a technology company? No again.
Welcome to Melvin. Melvin's is a daiquiri store.
I like to mix Panty Dropper and Dirty Banana together.
A laundromat. It's a deli, a 24-hour deli. Your order's ready.
Melvin's is a chicken place, a catering place. Melvin's is a place where everybody knows each other's name.
I got chill bumps this big. I don't even know why I'm crying. Everybody else crying. I'm crying.
Melvin's is an art gallery.
Hi, I'm Welvin Shalahorn. I've got that again.
We have legal services that Rick provides on Saturdays.
Everyone should have access to an attorney. Everyone.
It's an oasis, I feel. We get your clothes washed, or you can get a meal, or gamble.
Melba's is the brainchild of Scott and Jane Wolfe, New Orleans natives who have been together nearly their entire lives.
We've been married since I'm 15 years old. I met him at 13 years old. We went business at 17 years old with a child.
That first business was Wagner's, a small grocery store located in the dangerous Lower Ninth Ward.
It wasn't any scientific reason in why we were there. We just had to make a living. So we were not aware of the data around us that was extreme poverty, extreme crime. We were just rolling.
And boy, did they roll.
And then within 5 years, we were up to 10 locations. We had 300 employees, and then we got up to 20,000 customers per day, always in New Orleans, and always on fire.
And they lost it all during Hurricane Katrina. Melba's is their plan B, and a successful one at that.
So Melba's just became one of the fastest growing companies in America by Inc. magazine. We're ranked number one in Louisiana and number 121 in America.
And we take pride that it is a po'boy shop instead of an oil company.
Like a Ninth Ward version of Cheers, the series Melba's will chronicle the day-to-day adventures of the staff and regulars at one of the most successful and unorthodox businesses in America.
It's so one of a kind. It's that mix of everything they're doing in there. And it's the people. I mean, you can't make this up.
Joanna.
All right, well.
The man a mess.
Mama Lois, she's the face of Melba. She's our spokesperson.
I'm Mama at Melba's Old School Po' Boy, born and raised in the Ninth Ward, baby. And our soul food is the real deal.
Except he slammed the door right on our line. Yeah.
And in fact, I think, you know, she's dating now again.
I have a date tonight, and I'm also going to it once I finish.
You got home at 10
last night?
Yeah. What time he left?
Don't tell me he got free chicken wings.
Melba's is sort of that mythical place that you've heard about where, like, all these different tribes kind of come together. All these different lines that we have in New Orleans kind of blend there.
I think it really is an intersection between whites, blacks, and blues.
I'm gonna lay down my burden down by the riverside. Down by the riverside.
People to understand that Melba's just not just a place to eat, but a part of the community.
One of the things about Scott and Jane in the community, as their business has prospered, they have not just been takers, but rather they've been givers.
And I said, you have to pay a living wage. If you don't pay a living wage here, I don't want no part of it. So,
here we are. You about to cry?
Maybe.
They've always had their businesses in poor areas, and it works.
We're having fun with this one. This one is, I think we're more connected to the neighborhood and to the employees.
No, we're not more connected. We understand our place in the neighborhood.
You know, as Rodney King said, can't we all just get along? Melba's is that place where we can come, eat some good food, and all just get along.
I ain't gonna fight and kill, just living harmony.
That's what Melba's all about, reaching out. This is Reverend Raymond Brown, civil rights leader, and I am a number one fan of Melba's.